This is a very important panel because satellite operators, especially in the Arab region, where most of TV viewing is through satellite TV, it's pan-Arab. So I'll basically start with a general theme, the first point in our discussion, which is, what are your expansion plans? And why are you expanding for all the operators on the panel? We'll start right to left, I would say.
First, thank you, Jawad, for the invitation. So we at Eutelsat, we see very good growth coming from satellite TV, which is the default distribution technology in the region. So since 3 years, we almost doubled the number of satellites on 7-8 west position. And in August, we launched a new satellite called the Eutelsat 8 West B that will bring additional 20 transponders. So for HD, it will mean more six. For one transponder, is 6 channels. So it has a space for almost more than 100 channels. And we forecast that most of it will go for HD channel. And this, of course, this satellite is distributed through our partners in the region. So Nilesat, our valued partner, Mohammad Al-Haj, Gulfsat, and of course, Norsat and others. The region is going also through a transformation. So we are working on the interactivity, the hybridization of the satellite, and this challenge for us. That we are working on, and looking forward for the discussion. Thank you.
Arabsat.
Good morning. Good morning. Actually, we are Arabsat. I think everybody knows Arabsat. It has been established since more than 30 years. It is more than 30 years it has been established, and we are I believe we are the strongest satellite operator in the region. We have 6 satellites operational on orbit, more than 5 orbital positions. We own them. We are going now within 2 to 3 years. Our satellites will be coming almost 10 satellites. One satellite will be launched by the end of this year, which has Ka-band coverage in addition to transponders for TV at 26 degree orbital position to strengthen that position. We have very, very ambitious growth criteria, and we have just acquired, I mean 1 year ago, we acquired Hilasat, which is the European satellite operator. And we are having some kind of thoughts of going into Asia. Actually, we believe in the alliances and partnerships. We know that the Middle East is one of the biggest growing areas, although there is a huge competition in this area. But we believe that we have positioned ourselves in that area for all type of services, including, and there are many additional kind of services that that value added services that we provide even for TV to strengthen 26. For example, yesterday I think Director General of Ruya, he was asking about, yes, first Sayyid, he was asking about interactivity, and he was thinking of interactivity. I think this, what he is dreaming of, I think it is there. We have it. We have that service, and we can provide it immediately. And there is some channels are using that, which is HPB TV, France 24, for example, on Arabsat, it has that service. So we are ready for any type of services that may improve the quality, improve the accessibility, and we are looking also forward to cooperate with all satellite operators. We are always open. Thank you.
Mr. Mohammed. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Mohammed Al-Haj. I'm the chairman and CEO of Gulfsat, a communication company based in Kuwait. I would like to thank you, Mr. Jawad, for the invitation and being part of this panel. Before we talk about the expansion plan, I believe we need just to highlight about the needs and the vision in terms of the satellite, where we plan for the expansions later on. I believe the main key drivers, from my perspective, is the living style and the working style in terms of within a workplace environment. Customer expectation and especially the business entities are increased day by day in terms of service usage, the service creation, as well as capacity utilization and content delivery, where the method of content delivery changes between time to time. Customers always looking for high speed, high connectivity, high security, more interaction, as well as they always look for seeking for more contents, for faster delivery methods, using a wider spectrum in terms of anywhere, any place, using any device. So looking at all of those kind of factors, Gulfsat focusing on sky infrastructure as well as the ground infrastructures in terms of expansion of the ground infrastructure. We have a sister company called Gulfnet. So we are two companies, sky by Gulfsat, ground by Gulfnet. We complement. We see that satellite technology as well as will complement the other delivery methods. In a sense, as going back to yesterday's session, I believe Cisco, they predict an increase, and anyone increase of a global IP traffic up to 1,000 billion gigabytes, which is almost one zettabyte. This is by 2016. 80% out of this is generated by video content. And we see such as a backbone and as a to back up such kind of a traffic and connectivity, satellite will play a major role where we are expanding heavily on by adding the fleets. From the other hand, Gulfsat, our expansion plan is growing by interconnecting international POPs around multiple countries. We are connecting today up 22 countries. Basically, we do IP contribution as well as satellite contribution for carrying contents over the globe. That's basically to differentiate. That's also to add more cost-effective and competence for the last mile and for the customers in terms of a pricing structure and avoiding any intermediate for as a service carrying. So in general, we will be heading more into providing hybrid satellite terrestrial network other than typical satellite operator. Thank you.
Morning, everyone. Thank you, Jawad, for as well inviting me to be part of this distinguished meeting. In ABS satellite, we have been growing in the past 2 to 3 years on a rate of launching one satellite per year. And that's driven from the fact that there is a transformation in the way we use satellite, or the market look at the potential of satellite in many folds. Satellite has been an essential part of supporting data securities in Earth observation and imagery. Satellite, we've seen how much UAV is carrying images and data for use of security, especially in our region here, which is very crucial for the government to monitor and control borders and as well maintain the flow of this information for intelligence and for safety of the borders. IPTV has been also seen. We've seen Orange playing services like voice data and broadcast, and satellite has been a complementary, or I would say, part of the hybridization network, which is really a reality, where operators are offering what you call Play TV or Bay TV, giving customers the options to get voice, internet, and broadcast through the ADSL network or the ADSL network in the terrestrial where the coverage is there. And satellite as well plays as a complementary part in carrying TV broadcast to those areas that's not covered by the fiber. I think there's a great vision for there's a great vision for the future, and the vision of the 4G or maybe the 5G, where there is a prediction that the amount of data could go up to thousands of use than what we use today, which it is more to do with let's say two-third video transmissions through the multimedia market, and this already been predicted by Cisco, and lots of the operators are doing some load balancing, moving some voice traffic into the typical 3G and shifting data traffic into the satellite. So satellite has been contributing to support cellular operator with GSM backhauling and load balancing of the existing traffic. In ABS, we have as well looked at new innovative technologies, and the way we expanded, we looked at the possibility to bring the cost per megahertz or the cost of satellite megahertz down by adapting to the hybrid satellite. So we have came up with some Ka band high throughput capacity, which is essential. Again, UAV utilize a huge amount of data bits. And something else you need to look at is the spectrum crunch in our industry. There will be a trend of seeing operator launching satellites not into the typical frequency spectrum in C, Ku, or Ka band. Some other frequency spectrum may be seen in the near future as well to provide more spectrum to us to launch and expand our fleets and our satellites. I think this is it for now.
Thank you. So basically all major platforms on this panel are expanding. Specifically, what the new growth in the new demand, is it primarily broadcast, or is it broadcast and IP connectivity, broadcast IP connectivity, cellular and telecom backhaul for operators? How much weight does each of these segments take from the new demand? Is it mostly broadcast, mostly IP connectivity, and so on? So,
how do you see it? Is that for us, we see good potential from high definition TV. To give you an idea, today the percent of HD channel in the Arab world is only 8%, compared to Western Europe, which is more than 30-40%. And you know, when you migrate from a single definition to a high definition, you create more demand and satellite bandwidth. So as I said previously, the new satellites that we are launching this year, I would expect that will be filled mostly from this migration. Nevertheless, talking numbers, here the fixed broadband penetration is very low in the region. So the latest statistic that I have from ITU gives between 3-7%, which is very, very low. So all the services on OTT, etc., with very good quality, need huge infrastructure investment on terrestrial. I am sure that satellite will play also a role in bringing on-demand content. It needs cooperation with all the industry, so with telco, with satellite operator. We saw in different regions where the content is pushed on a local server, and then it can be distributed locally through different means, or directly to the set-top box of the user. And of course, the third growth is coming from broadband connectivity, so internet, etc. There will be always a problem in rural area where the fiber and microwave is extremely expensive to reach the last chunk of small villages and population. These mostly should be driven by governments and regulatory, we expect. And the fourth driver that we see it also as, I think is the next topic in your panel, is disaster relief, especially in central region where some political instability and terrestrial infrastructure that is worn up. So all these drivers are I would say, driving the demand on satellite, broadcast and data, but mostly the broadcast.
Thank you. No, actually, I think broadcasting is the dominating factor here. But because of that, as we said, as we saw yesterday, the content delivery is increasing. So the satellite business should also respond to that. But what we can see, however, we are in a convergence area, and I think that requires that some satellites or some capacities shall be increased for broadband services, e-governments, helping e-governments. And look at, for example, nowadays, during this era of kind of wars and so on, security, for example. Security is very, very, very essential here to cover the whole country. And that I think, in normal way, it cannot be achieved with the proper capacity unless you have a kind of, let's say, KA band kind of capacity that will give you a huge data streams. Therefore, we think that every country at the end of the day will have its own KA band service by itself, beams covering certain countries. So internally, they will have the whole type of services, either education, tele-education, or medicine, or security, or e-government. So although the broadcasting is and we will see in the future as for every area in the world, you will see local TV transmissions, local for certain cities, local for certain countries, and they are. So that KA band will serve that KA band type of transmission, will help that type of channels. So although the broadcasting is increasing, but at the same time, the broadband service where everything is involved in that transmission is also increasing. The type of network, the construction of the network itself within a country is changing. So the satellite shall cover that, and exactly, and that multi beams for multi countries, and that requires more orbital positions, more resources, and then more satellites. We are in Arabsat. We are going in that direction, and we have already certain agreements with certain countries to cover them directly, having their own control of that, of those beams from the country itself. Because if you put the control of that network somewhere in other country, let's say in Europe or in any way, that country will not accept that, even from security or even from the identity. So we are achieving that, and we believe that Arabsat is the most suitable, carrier to achieve that, because anyway, Arabsat is owned by Arab countries. Officially, it's owned by Arab countries, and every country feels that they own the whole system. So we have already in agreements with many countries to do that. This is why I said that within the coming 2, 3, or 4 years, we will have another 4 satellites coming on, carrying Ka band, covering the whole Arab world. And that, of course, will help the industry. It will increase the penetration. It will, and the idea of having the internet for all, every single place in the Arab world shall be covered by internet. That's, I think, this is the ultimate vision. Thank you.
Well, you've been asking about if there is where the demand is coming from. But okay, going back to kind of statistic in terms of the DTH platform, the broadcast side, I do remember in the 7-8 orbital position by 2010, been around 500 to 600 channels on that position, and today we reached to a 1,300 channel, which is almost double where we see there is a demand and a growth. Beside, most of those channels, as mentioned, are SD, standard definition, and there's a lot of enhancement in the picture quality and the back end of studios and, you know, the digital cameras, where most of the clients and customers moving to the high definition platform. And looking back at Gulfsat 20 years ago, because we started in 1995, we started as a VSAT player, and slowly we moved to the voice services, so it became terminating voice all over the globe. And in 2005, 2006, we started to move on the broadcast arena, and basically we found there's a demand. And I believe we're still focusing in those three arenas: voice, data, and video. And as of today, and because of the most of the business, I can see driven by political situation. So number one, media is being affected, which there is an increase. Data connectivity in a sector such as the military, where we have a terminology called MilSatCom, which is military satellite communication. There is a huge demand. And third, a lot of... Hello? Okay. Possibly, I've been talking about the politics, so someone cutting me off. So, well, looking at the situation in the Arab, I believe in the Arab world, and other regulation on the financial sectors where they have policies for disaster recovery and sustained connectivity. Satellite communication is the most sustainable delivery method, as delivering contents from point to point around the, over the globe without having any intermediate or dependency. Stability for the customer and national security and most of the defense, they recently focusing on the satellite communication to depend on their unified communication platform, and mainly for unifying the communication between three forces, land force, air force, as well as the Navy. Where they have a joint operation center, and the satellite, we see it now, is the only unified communication for such arena. So we believe it's, as from our point of view, it's a merge, it's converge. We, in our operation as of today, and our engineering behind in Gulfsat, their mindset, or they came up from two schools, satellite, TV broadcast transmission, voice engineer, as well as a data and ICT platform. So as a structure of the company, driving the demand, the future demand, we start even hiring and looking of a converged structure within our organization. So I believe the focus will be both in broadcast on data as well as in voice.
I think the overwhelming believe that we all know that the traffic or the will be almost two-thirds video. So if this is the case, then I think there's a statistic that talks about at least 32,000 TV distributions being doing direct to home and to the terrestrial network. And it is, in our region, it's different, let's say, from Europe. The trend in Europe, it's more into now mobility, maritime. It's this is where the Europe region is going towards. Lots of data traffic is seen in the transportation sector in Europe within the train. You know. Back